This year didn't quite go as I expected. I know that they never really do. But this year, where do I even start? I can still remember where I was 9 months ago when I had heard the news. But I didn't think it was going to impact me in the way that it has. We say things like unexpected and unprecedented. And those might be the best words. But I am sure of this. Everything has changed for me. I've got to figure out how life works now. I'm far from my family and don't know when I'll see them next. I wish they were with me, but I know that it's going to take some time. It's strange though. As much as the world feels against me, I still feel love. That's a surprise to me. Can I really talk about love when there's so much turmoil around? Everyone's angry with something. There's riots and uprisings, shouting at neighbors, falling out with family. And yet, I'm still pondering the love that's grown inside me. Can it make a difference in a world like this? But maybe it's our only hope. When all the possibilities are exhausted, perhaps the only thing that could save us is the impossible.
To the highest name of all. Thank you.
pregnant with the savior of the world. I think you're allowed to think that sounds ridiculous. I know I did. I'm not from a place where anything interesting happens. I didn't do anything to stand out from the crowd. Yet there was an angel telling me that Jesus was coming into the world through me. All my people believed that God would come and bring hope to us. As a child, the stories were grand and awe-inspiring. But instead of arriving on a chariot or with an army, the rescuer came in the same way we all do, in the womb of a pregnant mother. I thought God would come with a huge display of power. But instead, he comes to me, a teenage girl, and was born from me, a helpless baby. If God wanted to show off and impress us, this isn't the way I would have done it. Birthed in the presence of animals, people kept asking what this whole situation said about me. But the more that I think about it, the more I wonder what it says about him. If God is love, then this starts to make perfect sense. I loved this baby, the savior, from the moment I knew I was pregnant, just like any mother. It wasn't a love based on who he is or what he had done or what he would do. It was just love, unconditional. So what do you see in my Christmas story? Does my story show you a God who, like a mother, protects, rescues, shelters, anything at all that we need? And when asked why, all we can say is because he loves us. So around that manger, far from home, I wonder if this is the night where I started to understand God and love for the first time.
Here's what I know now. This is a dark world. But in the midst of this dark world, God happens. Love comes to us, in spite of us, regardless of how we are or what we do. And when it's here, we see that love is quite remarkable. It's a promise, a sign, a deep knowing that love will take away the brokenness, the pain, the hurt, and the fear. I know this because it's all I ever saw in Jesus. I wasn't the only one captured by his vision of life, his view of others, his way of being. There's really only one way to define his life: love. Has anyone ever loved anyone like he did? Regardless of who you were, where you were from, what you did, he loves. He showed us how to love. We talk about love. We think about love. We imagine it. But I wonder if it ever comes close to what he offers us. Love isn't something he offers sparingly, with strings attached, with conditions or costs. For Jesus, it was simply love, period. Nothing after that. No conditions, no boundaries, no exceptions. Because Jesus knew that love was the impossible thing that was going to save us all. Love. Period. That word, it ends the sentence. It's like a candle in the dark. It doesn't matter how big the room, or even how dark the room. That flicker, that moment of ignition, when the flame takes and starts to burn. At that moment, all you see is the light. As it was said of Jesus, the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness cannot overcome it. It tried. I saw it constantly. Accusations, violence, and even death. But his love overcame it all. No matter how heavy the darkness, the light of his love never flickered, nor was it snuffed out. It never changed, whether you met him at your worst moment or his. It was always the same. Love. Period.
Waits for a miracle. The heart longs for a little bit of hope. Oh, come, Emmanuel. A child prays for peace on earth, and she's calling out from a sea of hurt. Oh, come, Emmanuel. And can you hear the angels singing, glory to the light of the tears of a mother? A baby's cry is the sound of love. Come down, Emmanuel. He is the song for the suffering. He is Messiah, the Prince of Peace. Has come, he has come.
And this is what the story does. Like that candle, it draws our attention away from the darkness. It invites us to step towards the light. It reminds you that you are loved, always have been loved, always will be loved. When you know you are loved, you become someone who loves. And this is why the Christmas story matters, because you matter.
This is a story about love, about Jesus, who meets you in the middle of the mess, who finds you lost at the margins of your life, who revives you from the boredom of the mundane. And if you're risky enough to lean into this, to accept this, maybe even believe this, then you will find the one thing that sustains, guides, and holds through the fear, the turmoil, and the uncertainty.
When this masterpiece that we found in a manger finds you, maybe, just maybe this Christmas, you will know that what you want is what you already have been given. Love. Period.